Said things are kind of dull in a small town.
Yeah, who said that? Who said that? Let them come to Mayberry. They'll see.
That ain't much of an invitation.
Wasn't much of a thing to say.
Folks, why don't you visit us in Mayberry?
Hey, hey, Susie Q, what's cooking with you?
Your teeth look whiter than new, new, new.
My teeth aren't new, but my toothpaste is new Pepsodent. Get with it, kids. New package, new flavor, new formula, too, means brighter smiles for me and you.
You'll wonder where the yellow went when you brush your teeth with Pepsodent. The new formula with IMP gets teeth much whiter. You can see it cleans the stains and film away while Irium fights tooth decay.
You'll wonder where the yellow went when you brush your teeth with Pepsodent.
The taste is new, so fresh and clean. That new taste really lasts, it's keen. And while it makes your smile a rave, it also makes your breath behave. So start going steady right away with Pepsodent. Get some today.
You'll wonder where the yellow went when you brush your teeth with Pepsodent. Pepsodent, Pepsodent.
But I feel like I'm missing something. Something important that could affect my whole life.
Of course you're missing something, Charlie Brown. If you only brush your teeth, you're only doing part of the job. Brushing's not enough to really clean your teeth. You have to floss, too.
Flossing, of course.
Flossing cleans off the plaque between your teeth, where the toothbrush can't reach.
My dentist told me that plaque causes tooth decay and gum disease. Although you can't see plaque without coloring it, plaque is sticky goo that grows on your teeth.
And if you don't clean all the plaque off, it can cause decay and gum disease. My dentist and dental hygienist told me all about it, and I floss well every day. I'm going to floss now before I go over to see Schroeder's concert. I want my mouth to be clean and sweet-smelling for him. Come on with me.
Hey, let's take a minute and meet Clark Kent, the star of Superman.
Gee, Mr. Kent, what a breakfast Kellogg's Sugar Smacks make, huh?
That's right, Jimmy. That's why I never let business interfere with this meal.
Now, who could that be at this hour of the morning?
Well, good, you're both here. Now, we have an important assignment, and
Gee, can't it wait till after breakfast?
News can't wait, Kent. You know that. Now then.
Not even for new Sugar Smacks, Chief?
No, I say we have this important... Why, yes. Don't mind if I do.
You know, Chief, I have a hunch that your important assignment was having some Sugar Smacks right here.
Didn't I say that news can't wait?
That's right. And folks, get these better than ever puffs of wheat. They're sugar toasted and candy sweet. They're Kellogg's new Sugar Smacks. You like them.
You bet. Just get Kellogg's Sugar Smacks, brand new.
May
is busting out all over our local public TV station.
With a brilliant all-star festival
of new television specials.
Monday, May 8th. Thursday, May 11th. Monday, May 15th. Thursday, May 18th. And Monday, May 22nd. And always special in May
or any other month.
Celebrate May
on public television.
Coming up in full bloom
on your local public TV station.
For animated cartoon adventure, suspense, and humor, watch Rocky and His Friends over most of these stations. Check your local... Now, wait a minute. Who are you?
Allow me to introduce myself. Boris Badenoff, world's greatest no-goodness.
But you can't interrupt the announcement.
Who says, wise guy?
Besides, what do you mean Rocky and His Friends are unfair?
Unfair to Local 12, Villains, Thieves, and Scoundrels Union.
But how?
Just watch. Squirrel walks down the street. I drop safe on him like any self-respecting villain. Who gets hit? Me. I send Lady Spy with package, which is really bomb. Door gets locked. She can't get out. Who gets blown up? Me.
Then you want us to change the plot?
No, just give me top billing.
Impossible. TV villains never get top billing.
Oh.
So be sure to tune in for Rocky and His Fiend. Now, wait a minute. That's supposed to be Friends. Who stole those letters?
Never underestimate the power of a schnook.
Tune in Rocky and His Friends for fun, joy, happiness, and good cheer.
Who needs it?
Watch the Bullwinkle Show!
Remember, Bullwinkle rhymes with, couldn't we call it the Clyde Show?
Faster than a speeding turtle. More powerful than Grandma Moses.
Luke in the sky.
It's a bird.
It's a plane.
It's Bullwinkle.
Nope, it's a bird.
Bullwinkle, you're incorrigible.
I'm in color, too.
Hi, I'm a tree. Now, lots of you folks think all we trees do is just stand around and soak up the sun. Have a little drink of water. And talk with the little birdies. But a tree also faces a lot of danger. Like if I don't get enough sunlight,
I'll be like this.
Or if it's really cold, I can get bitten by old Jack Frost.
Ouch.
And then there's those pesky little insects. They can chew me to pieces. And the wind. Can break off one of my limbs. But the worst danger I face is fire, because fire can burn me up. So please think before you strike. Be careful with fire.
Everybody wants to live a long time.
Even a tree.
On a cold December night 2,000 years ago, a family of strangers sought shelter in the town of Bethlehem.
No room at the inn.
An enchanting story of the Nativity, as seen through the eyes of the animals who shared their stable with Mary and her child.
Wake up, everybody! Wake up! A miracle has happened!
A holiday season special for the whole family. The Night the Animals Talked.
Thursday on Welcome Back, Cotter, the Sweat Hogs go looking for a thrill. Then Dee's got a date with her very first boyfriend. It's What's Happening. And Wojo has a problem.
I'm having trouble in bed. I mean, I speak.
Then catch up on all the soap you missed and decide for yourself who killed Peter Campbell.
I think that there is a curse on this family.
Well, if there isn't, there should be.
Soap!
Watch tomorrow, starting at 8, 7 Central and Mountain. You're on ABC.
Thursday's a full night of comedy, starting with a special edition of Happy Days.
Talk about hot dates.
I'm madly in love.
And Mark's new flame.
Oh, no.
But Jack gives up girls on Three's Company.
You want someone to talk to you?
Yeah.
Vodka?
Then it's bumper-to-bumper laughs with the gang from Taxi.
You can't buy a baby.
We got a receipt.
Barney Miller.
Isn't that wonderful?
And Soap on a special night of comedy, Thursday.
Shape and mutants hell-bent on destroying the world. Mankind has tampered with the unknown, and now it's a revolution of evolution.
They're big. They're terrible.
Big and terrible.
And they're coming right for you.
Doggone, I wish we had some nitro.
Science is baffled. The army is helpless. Has mankind seen its end?
Science and all science, we're getting out of here.
For more information, keep watching this broadcast, or try logging onto our website at ampop.com. This March, they're marching your way. So try to run, try to hide, grab your loved ones tight and throw them in front of you as you try to escape from American Pop's Adam Age Monsters. Tonight at 10.
Fortunately, I made the putt, and now all we have to do is wait and see what happens.
Yeah. This is when you need something more than a soft drink. Nothing soft about the taste of Coca-Cola. It's unmistakable. Lifts your spirits, boosts your energy.
Things go better with Coca-Cola. Things go better with Coke.
What would happen if we could change the course of the Gulf Stream or the other great ocean currents? Or warm up Hudson Bay with atomic furnaces?
Extremely dangerous questions, because with our present knowledge, we have no idea what would happen. Even now, man may be unwittingly changing the world's climate through the waste products of his civilization. Due to our release through factories and automobiles every year of more than 6 billion tons of carbon dioxide, which helps air absorb heat from the sun, our atmosphere seems to be getting warmer.
This is bad.
Well, it's been calculated a few degrees rise in the Earth's temperature would melt the polar ice caps. And if this happens, an inland sea would fill a good portion of the Mississippi Valley. Tourists in glass-bottomed boats would be viewing the drowned towers of Miami through 150 feet of tropical water. Foreign weather, we're not only dealing with forces of a far greater variety than even the atomic physicist encounters, but with life itself.
Dick Powell. Shane Gray Theater.
A sheriff's badge. It's been worn by every famous lawman from Wild Bill Hickok to Gary Cooper. And I reckon Coop wore it more than anybody. Being sheriff in the early days was a pretty rough job, but the pay was quite high, $125 a month, plus a bonus for each arrest. Sheriff Pat Garrett is best known for killing the notorious gunman, Billy the Kid. His bonus for that job, $2.50. Of course, in those days, that was a month's rent. Sometimes, in the case of an emergency, a sheriff would ride shotgun for Wells Fargo. Oh, by the way, the last stage holdup was July 9th, 1915, in Yellowstone. The bandit got $200. One of the passengers on that stage was Bernard Baruch. In our show this week, I get a chance to play a sheriff. Appearing with me are Robert Vaughn and Beverly Garland.
You got my letter?
Yeah, all the way from Cambria, I had me a wager going. With my horse. Now, he bet me he wanted somebody shot. And I bet him he was wrong.
Your horse wins, Johnny.
And then he gets an extra apple.
See ya! Help me! Somebody help me! Torpedo!
Keep cool! Use your head, don't lose it! Open and close your legs like a scissor! Keep up a steady rhythm! Now cup your hands downward and move them in a figure eight motion.
I'm treading water.
You got it. Never play around water alone.
Now I know.
And knowing is half the battle.
G.I. Joe.
Tonight on The Incredible Hulk, special guest star Esther Rolls in trouble and McGee's closing in on David Banner. Then on The Dukes of Hazzard, a trio of curvaceous car strippers teams up with Boss Hogg to frame Uncle Jesse. And on a special Knot's Landing, will Gary break up with Val over Lucy?
Mama, please come back to Dallas with me.
It's all on CBS tonight.
What new television show are you most looking forward to this year?
The Farmer's Daughter. Because she's such a wonderful Swedish girl.
You must be Swedish.
Oh, no.
Where are you from?
Richmond, Virginia.
All right, you guys, we gotta move fast. Benny, Choo-Choo, get me some mosquito nets. Spook, Fancy, check the airport. Brain?
Yeah, I know. Back your bags.
Glad you're paying attention. Now, blur, boys, blur.
In one of their most quick-witted creations, Bill Hanna and Joe Barbera brought a city-wise alley cat to primetime television.
All I remember is this one drawing at the time in color. And I went into Ollie Trade. I said, here's a terrific character. And he just looked at it and said, yeah, looks good. He said, we'll buy it. That's the end of it. So a primetime show with one drawing.
Yeah, looks good. We'll buy it.
And then after that, we had to go in and develop all the characters and go into storyboard and whatever it is, but it was sold.
ABC agreed to the idea, and Joe Barbera sketched out and wrote two episodes in one afternoon. Sandwiched between The Steve Allen Show and Hawaiian Eye on ABC, and opposite The Joey Bishop Show on NBC, and Checkmate on CBS, Top Cat aired on Wednesday nights in prime time from 8:30 to 9 p.m. Top Cat shows had a great mix of urban alley cat characters with engaging dialogue but fewer cartoon sight gags than any of the other Hanna-Barbera creations up until that time. In terms of script, Top Cat is probably the most sophisticated cartoon series Hanna-Barbera ever produced for television.
Quick, Choo-Choo, a hanky.
Shites, pants, socks. And you know what? here we are. A hanky.
Bill Hanna said that when Joe Barbera and he had the freedom, without all the restrictions of program practices and the network rules to live by, they were able to create shows that were funnier and more sophisticated.
Benny, take the kid over to the orphanage and drop him off.
You mean you're gonna put the baby in the orphan home, T.C.?
Sure, what else? That's what it's for, isn't it?
Yeah, but I was an orphan once.
So what do you want, a medal or something?
No, but...
They took good care of you, didn't they? Gave you meals, clothes, a place to flop, even your own toothbrush, right?
Yeah, but...
But what? Don't tell me they didn't furnish toothpaste.
No, I got toothpaste.
Okay, so you got everything. What's the big beef against the orphanage?
You just don't get any love there.
You don't get any what?
Love!
Huh?
Times do I have to tell you? Lay off my phone. It's for official police business.
The Top Cat Clan's favorite target is the police officer on the beat, Officer Dibble. Thoroughly confused but completely undaunted by Top Cat's adventures, the persistent and dedicated Dibble takes his duties as a policeman seriously.
All right, DC, freeze. How many times have I told you to keep your hands off my phone?
Oh, how thoughtless of me, Officer Dribble. I mean, Dibble. I didn't keep count. Should I have?
TC and Dibble are constantly engaged in a battle of wits. Officer Dibble is the reason Top Cat's crafty maneuvering stays on the fringe of the law and goes no further. The voices in Top Cat brought a range of New York dialects to one show. The nasal Queensborn approach of the long-suffering cop on the beat, Officer Dibble, was played by Alan Jenkins. The squealing Brooklynite inflected phrases from Choo Choo were performed by Marvin Kaplan. The hip speak, heard from Village Bound Spook, was voiced by myself, and I also played the brain. The clip tones of aspiring Manhattan socialite Fancy Fancy were performed by John Stevenson. Lovable Benny the Ball was played by Maurice Gosfield. And the star of the show, Top Cat, was voiced by comedian Arnold Stang. Hanna-Barbera created 30 half-hour episodes of Top Cat. The show was broadcast in black and white, but was created in color. Series reruns began immediately, finding an instant and long-lasting kids' audience on Saturday mornings. Top Cat returned in a feature-length animated movie made for television, Top Cat and the Beverly Hills Cats.
It's Miami Mice, quick, Fancy. Time to play Wilderness.
Your little windshield washing scam is over.
Sorry, T.C. He was my first good deed.
I wonder who could have given him that bag of dirt. You know what this means, T.C.
Of course I do, Dibble.
It means that poor brain here is still suffering from a childhood affliction.
He is?
Yeah. Shh. Don't spread the word, but he's a terminal twit.
Thanks, DC. I needed that.
Through syndicated television reruns, millions still enjoy Top Cat in nearly 50 countries throughout the world.